All right, so I'm here. I'm talking to somebody, Gary, and I'm talking to somebody, and I'm gonna look at your video over here. What you got cooking over here? The Tower Falls. Yeah. Well, you want me to say who it is? All right. It's Anna Bannon I'm talking about over here. Anna.
Pretty frightening image. Almost always it shows a tower that's struck by lightning that has two figures falling from it. When it comes up in readings, people tend to be less than happy. It looks pretty foreboding.
Yeah, the tower's always...
And I mean, to some extent it is. Basically, it normally happens when our lives have become overwhelmed by bullshit, basically.
Yes.
The lies we tell ourselves.
Yes, Gary.
Some of the falsehoods that we might have even have been constructing our lives around.
Thank you, Gary.
All come home to bite us in the ass. Yes,
I hate getting bitten in the ass.
There's another time when the tower can come up, however. It's when we finished one chapter in our lives and we're ready to move on to the next one.
Right.
And yet we don't have the impetus to go. We know it's time. We know it's time to move on.
Right.
And yet.
And yet.
We're still there.
We're still.
When that happens.
Cowards.
Our higher selves, the universe, Godhead, whatever you want to call it, karma tends to come along and shake us loose. How hard the shaking often depends on just how much we need our lives rattled and shaken up.
Karma likes to do a lot of
then
shaking.
Then with any
though.
Luck, we start building our lives again on the basis of what's true for us now and on some basis of a higher truth for us. Or if not higher truth, perhaps a clearer understanding of what truth is. For deeper insight, I'm going to read what Aleister Crowley has to say about the Tower card in his Book of Thoth. 16. The Tower, or War. This card is attributed to the letter Pe, which means mouth.
What?
It refers to the planet Mars.
Control.
In its simplest interpretation, it refers to manifestation of cosmic energy in its grossest form. The picture shows the destruction of the existing material by fire. It may be taken as a preface to Atu 20, the Last Judgment, i.e., the coming of a new aeon. This being so, it seems to indicate the quintessential quality of the Lord of the Aeons. At the bottom part of the card, therefore, is shown
though?
The destruction of the old established
aeon
by lightning, flames, engines of war. In the right-hand corner are the jaws of Dis, belching flames at the root of the structure. Falling from the tower are broken figures of the garrison.
The volume went off. What's going on, Gary? What are you doing? I don't hear anything.
It'll be noticed
okay.
that the figures have lost their human shape. They have become mere geometrical expression. So, you have it that the Tower Force comes, and the old established order, the lives we're used to living, the ones that maybe we've become too complacent in,
yes.
or that we're ready to change because a new aeon's upon us.
Right.
So, boom!
Oh!
The lightning strikes, the tower comes toppling down,
Krunk.
And we're kind of forced into rebuilding, starting that new chapter
right.
in our lives. We might not feel like we're ready,
right.
but either we make our choices or they're made for us. When the time comes to move, we
I'm
move
here.
One way or another, or the universe moves us. Back now to the Book of Thoth by Aleister Crowley. This suggests
what?
Another, and totally different, interpretation of the card.
What happened?
To understand this, it is necessary to refer to the doctrines of yoga, especially those most
yep.
widely current in southern India, where the cult of Shiva, the destroyer, is paramount.
Shiva!
Shiva is represented as dancing upon the bodies of his devotees. To understand this is not easy for most Western minds. Briefly, the doctrine is that the ultimate reality, which is perfection, is nothingness. Hence, all manifestations, however glorious, however delightful, are stains. To obtain perfection, all existing things must be annihilated. The destruction of the garrison may therefore be taken to mean their emancipation from the prison of organized life, which was confining them. It was their unwisdom to cling to it.
Emancipation, the above, proclamation,
should
people!
Should be clear that magical symbols must always be understood in a double
Juneteenth!
Sense. Yeah. Each contradictory of the other.
It's Juneteenth!
These ideas blend naturally with the higher and deeper significance of the card. There is a direct reference to this card in the Book of the Law. In chapter 1, verse 57, the goddess Nuit speaks, "Invoke me under my stars. Love is the law. Love under will.
Love
or let the fools mistake love.
Under will.
Where there are love and love.
Love.
There's the dove and there's the serpent. Choose ye well. He, my prophet, hath chosen, knowing the law of the fortress,
fuck
and
the serpent,
mysteries
the dragon!
Of God. The dominating feature of the card is the Eye of Horus.
The dragon!
Also the Eye of Shiva, on the opening of
the
which, according to the
of
legend of this
Shiva
quote, the universe is
Linga.
Besides this, there is a special technical meaning, which is explained openly to initiates of the 11th degree of the OTO, a grade so secret that is not even listed in the official documents. It is not even to be understood by the study of the eye in Atu 15, the devil. Perhaps it is lawful to mention that the Arab sages and the Persian poets have written, not always guardedly, on the subject. Bathed in the effulgence of this eye, which now assumes even a third sense that indicated in Atu 15, are the dove bearing an olive branch and the serpent in the above quotation. The serpent is portrayed as the lion serpent, the Anubis, or Abraxas. These represent the two forms of desire, what Schopenhauer would have called the will to live and the will to die. They represent the feminine and masculine impulses. The nobility of the latter is possibly based upon recognition of the futility of the former. Note to Anna and Pat and anybody else who's listening.
I'm listening.
This is perhaps why the renunciation of love in all the ordinary senses of the word has been so constantly announced as the first step towards initiation. This is an unnecessarily rigid view. This trump is not the only card in the pack, nor are the will to live
rigid
and the will
as
to die compatible.
This
becomes clear as soon as life and death are understood.
Raw.
See Atu 13. As phases of a single manifestation of energy. After the tower comes the healing energy of the star. We are devastated on the ground, thrown out of our tower, having to rebuild. And the star, Mother Nuit, helps us to heal and rebuild again. Peace and love, everyone.
Peace and love, Gary. All right, close your eyes, son. All right, close your eyes, son. I don't think you want to see what's about to happen. Oh, yeah? The neighbors are complaining? Yeah. All right, let me get out of this thing over here.